The Marine Unit of the Royal St. Lucia Police Force has been praised for being one of the most active in the OECS sub-region, having netted more drug seizures than any other Marine Police unit last year. That, Superintendent Milton Desir says, is because of regular patrols of the island's waters. Despite severe limitations exacerbated by the recent withdrawal of U.S. government support to the police, he says the unit has been able to achieve its mandate of providing maritime security. Using the recent Atlantic rally for cruisers as an example, he says the unit was able to provide around-the-clock security for visiting yachtsmen.
We had defenders stationed there for the duration. It's a month for the duration of the time it was stationed at Rodney Bay because of all these activities there. However, we cannot have a vessel deployed in every establishment, so on. The owners and persons responsible for this establishment have a duty for their own, the security of their own establishments, and we will assist in whatever way that is possible.
Marine police must respond to a number of security and other threats, and with only four vessels and 61 police officers split between two stations, the strain on the department, Daisy says, is significant. Fuel and routine maintenance of police vessels, he says, are quite costly. In spite of the challenges, he says, the department works closely with a number of other agencies, including the Air and Seaports Authority, Customs, and the Soufriere Marine Management Area Office, to enforce existing maritime safety regulations.
Especially on the day that you have cruise ships in port, that most you would have increased stores down from between Marigo and Soufriere, and we too, there is need for us to have patrols in that area. And as we speak, actually it was about 2 weeks ago that we have commenced a patrol in that area. Every day there is a boat dedicated for that area, and it's dedicated for that purpose.
The frequency of crimes committed against people aboard yachts in the Eastern Caribbean is a concern for tourism officials, who fear that such incidents could scare yachtsmen away from the island and the region. For the DBS News World, Kendal Burton reporting.